shit. Yes.
MP3 player?
Yes. Yes, push, oh. Push, yes.
Big L, rest in peace. Rest in peace.
My name is Jewlz Perry, and I'm Lamont Big L's mother.
One of the best yet. We've got it.
You can feel the realness. In this business of rap.
Go ahead.
He was just raw with it. He just, you know, he would just battle anybody that came on the block.
Amateur battle, first place, 1992. We beat out like 2,000 dudes, man. That's serious. He was proud of this.
I remember when he first started rapping, he was talking about how he was trying to get in the music business.
They was down in Rockin' Will, and Lord Finesse was there.
Doing a mixtape or something. L just went, you know what I mean? Got in the cab, went down there.
So he was spitting in the background. Lord Finesse heard him, was like, damn, shorty, ill.
Like, L was one of his best lyricists. Like, his metaphors and his similes was phenomenal.
You know, was... Everybody Finesse bought was nice. He bought A to me, and he bought L to me.
This dude, yeah, I remember he just kept talking about this dude, Big L is sick. He his rhymes are incredible. And boom. They did the Yes You May remix.
When I heard Big L give it him, I'm like, oh, my attention went from here to there. Like, you know what I'm saying? I think that went with everybody, man, because he really was like, came out of nowhere with the way his bars was in his delivery.
Yes You May remix, Lord Finesse, crazy, crazy, crazy.
That was the truth. That was the lyricist.
You could tell in the early stage who was like, him and Finesse was like, you know, they had the same type of rhyme style, and then he just start coming up.
So I was real excited to hear that Big L was coming with an album and he was getting his opportunity to shine.
Focus on the real. Big L gives up a clear view of lifestyles of the poor and dangerous. The debut album from Big L, the newest member of the Digging in the Crates crew, features top-notch production from Buck Wild, Lord Finesse, Showbiz, and Craig Boogie. Big L, Lifestyles of the Poor and Dangerous, cause it's like that, on Columbia.
When L got signed, it was big, you know, so we knew we had one of our own about to, you know, blow up. I remember the Source and different magazines just to give him high praise. He used to be on Scratch and Bob Depot's radio station. When he first got on, he had, the anticipation was big.
I did Double Sun, man. I ain't want to be responsible for that shit.
Remember the first time I heard, when I was 12, I went to hell for stuffing Jesus. When I was 12,
yo, this dude is crazy. When he told me the rhymes to that shit, I said, yo, you really going to say this shit on wax, man? He said, man, I don't give a fuck.
When I was 12,
I went to hell
for stuffing Jesus. When I was 12,
you're
ready. Yeah. I'm gonna explain the story. Check it out. Ayo, 5/3/0/7/4. A little bro was born with the mind of a psycho. They first knew I was a crazy nigga when my mother came home and found out I killed the babysitter. I did more crime in due time. Started my life of crime about 9, going out for mine. I made every little kid from a hood run. I was just like that.
We went up to Sony, right? We played this shit for the dude that was in charge, right? I don't know if he was some satanic worshiping motherfucker.
He's probably like, yeah.
Daddy, yeah. He's like, yeah, this is the shit right here. We gonna put this one out first.